Hey, what's up, guys? Charlie here. Welcome back to Prison Architect. This woman here, apparently, is Gordon's wife. 31 years old. She was just in here. We caught her. I caught her after they stopped. After they stopped their visitation. I noticed Gordon was like going this way, basically. And I was kind of like, why are you heading that direction? It makes no sense. Like, well, Gordon's 29. He likes the older women. Yeah. Maybe she's... I can't imagine how smart she'd be staying with him. I mean, the guy's already got 2,188 years. He's been in prison for 31 years. Wait, hold on. How does that even work? His wife is 31 years old, but he's been in prison for 31 years? I mean, how does this... He's been in prison longer than his age. He's been in prison since 2 years before he was born. How does this even... Prison Architect, what are you doing here? So, he's been in prison his entire life, plus his mother was also in prison for 2 years. I get it. So, like, basically, Gordon's mom was in prison, and then 2 years into her sentence, she had Gordon. Who he then, of course, was already somehow magically married to this woman, who was 2 at the time. No, he was 0 at the time. She was being born too. That is, I don't know. Well done, Prison Architect. You've created a paradox that I can't explain. You know what? I think Scott Gordon is a time lord. That's the only thing I can think of. This is, yeah, I think this is, maybe Gordon is like the next, it will be revealed later that he's a time lord. I'm afraid I don't have a TARDIS for you. Okay, so in this episode, what I want to do is I want to make sure that we're set to turn on the cell qualities because I want to get a good feel for how that will look. And first things first, though, let's talk about exports here. I've gone ahead and I put the garbage to be equal with the exports, and this is actually working really well. This is working terrifically. You see our money flow now. Amount of money we have, it's pretty good. This number is actually much lower. It was much higher yesterday. I'm not sure why it's so low now, but it was much higher yesterday. I think it's low now because I've bought a whole lot of stuff. I've expanded the suburbs quite a bit, okay? And I think I'm getting close to turning it on. But there's still a few things I have to take care of with it, like utilities and things like that. If I take a look at the... Hold on. Let's get this guy... Let's get you sorted out. Sorry about that, workman. I know you want to just do your job, so we'll do it. This canteen doesn't have... The room is not extended into the serving table because I don't want cooks to bring food to it. So, utilities. Let's take a look at that. We've got them run out through here. Pretty good. Everything's mostly hooked up. Looks like I'm missing this metal detector. Wow, where's the nearest one? I guess I'll have to go... I'll just go like this. But I'm missing that metal detector. I think that's it, though. As far as water goes, we should be good. Yeah, except for this. So, there we go. And... That's pretty much it. Hot water. Looking okay there. Well, we got some stuff to do here. Not sure why they didn't install it all the way. But, okay. I drew the line all the way across and it didn't work. Maybe they couldn't reach it or something and they canceled the job. I don't know. This needs to be extended. This one needs to be extended all the way through here. It needs to be extended up to here, up to... This pipe's good. Yeah, all this stuff is good as soon as they build those pipes out. So let's just have them like prioritize everything over here. And then we have some stuff we have to draw down here. I'm probably going to need to expand this main pipe. It's probably going to have to come all the way down like this. So it's not really favorable. I'd rather it not do that, but I guess that's just going to have to be the way it is for now. I'm actually going to take and do this with this pipe just to kind of give it a hard sort of stop at the tip. And I'll do the same thing with this one. Kind of run this maybe this way or something. until I need to go another direction, and then I will. But okay, so basically what I want to do is I want to turn on cell quality ratings in this episode. But I'm giving you a tour of the town, too, because there's going to be a whole bunch of stuff. There's going to be a big common room here. Is this a common room or is it something else? I thought this was a shop, but now I'm thinking I could turn this into something else. I was also thinking about having, like, a school, right? A big community school. And I thought maybe this was the school. Maybe this was the school. How did I plan this out? Let's see. If I go objects, is this 5x5? 5x5 there, and 5x5 here. Yeah, I think this was my school, I think. The school building was going to have two classrooms. And then, actually, let's build the school down here. This is a better place for it. I have a plan how I want the school. And I think it's not really that original, but I think as far as prison architect is concerned, it's a pretty cool idea. I want to have the school be a rather large complex. Kind of like maybe all of this area. Probably will be all of this. And it will probably go something like this, all the way to the end of the streets. Maybe we'll leave a little bit of gap around the edges for some grass or something, but like all the way around, right? Now we're going to have classrooms. We'll have like maybe two or three classrooms. So let's maybe just weigh this out. 5x5. Let's do 6x6 on the classrooms. That would actually make it 5x5, I think. But if I do like this and go like this, what is this? This is 6x5. Okay, well, fine. We'll go like this then. So that's going to be a 6x6 classroom. We'll do the same thing out like this. Right? We'll just have them next to each other. That's not a big deal. I'm okay with that. But what I want to do, right, we'll have the classrooms here. And this is obviously not going to be used like expectations. It's not really going to be used this way, but whatever. We'll have three classrooms. Then I want to have like a cafeteria for the students. Again, it's not going to be used that way, but sure. So I'll have like a cafeteria area kind of like over here. And I think actually I'll pair the walls up. I'll make them match. But then over here, we want the gymnasium, right? Every school has a gym. I'm actually going to have to extend this a little bit. And what I want to have in here is a couple of training basketball places and then one big court, right? With a whole bunch of stadiums and all that stuff. And that's all going to be kind of like the school for the whole neighborhood, right? It's not going to be, obviously, it's not going to work that way, but it'll have, like, when we do buildings down this direction and wrap them over, this will sort of be like the school for the neighborhood. I think it's not going to work the way I'm describing, obviously, but I think that's an interesting plan. So I'm going to leave that the way that is. We'll have three classrooms, a cafeteria area, which will serve as a canteen, which these guys are actually going to be going to several different canteens. There's one up here, right here. And then there's going to be another one down here, right there. There's a little one there. I thought I was going to do one here too, but now I'm thinking I might turn that into like a common room. And then there'll be one here. And eventually I'll have one down here too. So there's always a place to eat, just a variety of different places to eat for all these people. And it'll be good. So since there's this, what I probably should do is expand on this exports idea. And I'll get to that in a second. Yeah, I don't need to get to it in a second. There's exports here now and exports here now. And then the trash just goes here. So all these trucks that come in, right? We'll just watch the truck. All the trucks that come in, they'll get exports. But sometimes they'll also get trash brought into the trucks too. So like this one. Well, no, it's not going to do it because my example's crap. Oh, well, we'll see. Sometimes they'll bring trash out. Sometimes they'll do exports. So we don't have as many exports going out. But it's still a fair amount. I think it's pretty good. Oh. Gordon, now you just went ahead and had a visitor. And you're already at it again. What are you doing here, Gordon? Come on, man. He's over in this cell now. And there's a sniper. You stupid, stupid, stupid sniper are not supposed to be walking around with a damn rifle in the middle of Supermax. Okay? I don't know why you're over here. There's no reason for you to ever be over here, ever, for any reason, ever. Why in the world are you over there? There's no part of pathing that's requiring that. You go this way, and you jump in the sniper tower there. You should exit the sniper tower there, go this way, through these doors, and out this way. If you didn't do that, at least you would go through these doors and out this way, because it's the fastest route. Right? I've intentionally made this route faster than this route, so that you would do that. That is concerning to me. And I can't put an armory. What's this going? Is this a... Really? I put a staff door here? Why did I put a staff door there? Why is there a staff door there? Get rid of that. Yeah, so, like, I don't know why the sniper was doing that, but I'm glad Gordon didn't get the sniper rifle, because maybe that's what he was doing. Maybe he was trying to get the sniper rifle. Look, it's quicker. It's quicker. Wait a second. That's why they're doing it. Oh, that's why they're doing it. If he comes from this way, right, he goes through one door, two doors, then he walks all the way around three doors. It's the fastest route. It's the route with the least number of doors. That's why he's doing it that way. So I need to make this route the fastest route. Otherwise, Gordon can do that too. He can walk all the way around. Oh, wow. Yeah, what a security loophole that is. Well, we're taking care of that right now. We are taking care of that right now, sir. I'm gonna put a door there. And let's put it there. And there. And there. And there. Uh-huh. And then... I'll put one there. Now we've got lots of doors around the edge. Good luck with that. And let's put the... put the servos like this. If I place these, if I rotated the doors correctly, they should open into the fences. They should. We'll see if that actually happens. And then I need electricity to run through those. So let's bring this electrical line to there, I guess. We'll wrap this around and go all the way like that. And then we'll just kind of do one of these numbers like this. Like that. And there. Get on it, workmen. We found a security hole. That might be how he got so far last time. You guys didn't see it. He did it while I was trying to build the town, but he actually made it to here, right? He got sniped right here. But he made it to here, and if he had gotten through this door, I mean, he would have went this way, which these snipers would have, you know, seen him then, but he's super fast, so I don't know if they would have reacted in time, but he might have got outside. He might have. Been very close, but he got here. That's the furthest I've ever seen him go, and that's why I put these doors in place, because as soon as I saw him get there, I went, okay, we need more obstructions. But now I'm thinking he might have, because he was in this cell before. I'm thinking he took this cell, since there's no doors this way. I didn't do this on this side, because I figured, why do I have to? So now I think he went this way, all the way around, which the snipers should have been able to see him all the way through here. Which is why I really wasn't concerned with it, because the sniper should have seen him all the way around. But apparently he evaded it, or he just too fast? I don't know. He should have still had to bust down this door. But either way, we're going to take care of that problem right now. And we're going to go ahead and punish him. He's at 2,213 years now. Crazy stuff happening with Gordon. And while you guys were out, I was actually doing this in the Twitch stream. I live stream now. I'm starting to live stream in Twitch. Just like the little things I'm doing behind the scenes and stuff, I'll turn Twitch on. So randomly I turn Twitch on. I'm not going to like schedule anything. So if you're following me on Twitch, link in the description, you'll sometimes see some behind the scenes stuff, I guess. But while I was doing that, Brown actually committed a crime. Well, 19. He tried to escape, right? He's been here for 42 days. That's the only thing he did, right? He had 40 days without incident. And now, if I look at room quality, he's no longer deserving a 10, right? Now he's entitled to a 0 because of his escape attempt. So as he does less, as he builds up that days without incident, he'll slowly earn a better cell. But until then, he goes down here. Now, down here, I'm actually really concerned about this because there's no radiators in these cells. There's no warmth. And I really think there needs to be warmth. So what I kind of want to do here is what I really want to do is break my town system. I want to break it to where I make this foundation and put on a heater in here, but I'm not going to do it. So I need to find a way to do it without that. So I think what the alternative here to do is I'm going to take away this fence. Ooh, that kind of defeats the purpose of these doors. Hang on. I think I have a solution to that, though. Yes, I have a solution to that problem. It kind of impedes staff a little bit more, but it is what it is. Oh, Burgess's wife. Oh, yeah. She's ready. She's wearing the lipstick. She's got kind of this whole punk rocker hairdo style going on. Okay. I see how it is, Burgess. I see how the kind of women you're into. let's get this taken care of. I want to do that. Let's not do this. Let's do this, but let's not do this one. And then I'm going to make this a wall instead. So what I could do, actually, now, hang on. I have a better idea, actually. Why don't we do this instead? Why don't we take the foundation, concrete foundation, let's expand it, okay, to there. We'll just expand it one up, right? And if we expand it one up, what we can do is I can take these solitary doors, let's dismantle those. Dismantle. It's gonna be expensive, but I don't care. I want the Supermax to not be cold because then they're just gonna act up more. All right, so let's get rid of the fence first. And we might as well just get rid of this door too, because this doesn't need to be done. So we'll get that done. Let's go ahead and open that up. And we'll let the workmen get on doing that. All right. While that's happening, let's take a look at the needs or the levels that everyone else deserves. So it looks to me like we have a lot of, there's a lot of empty cells. The dash mark means the cell is empty. So this one is a 2. He deserves a 2 and he's in a 2. This one deserves a 1, but he's in a 2, right? If they come up here a little further, we'll probably see a few 3s. Yeah, so this guy's he deserves a 3. He's entitled to a 3, but he's in a 2, right? So in this case, what would happen with all these 1s right here is that all of these 1s would be vacated. They'd all be kicked out of these cells because you do not get a cell that's more than what you deserve, right? This is the reason why we don't have this mechanic active right now, because of Gordon, who always deserves a 0, and yet all these cells were 2s. So he would always get put to the holding cells. What I actually kind of think I want to do is I want to get rid of the canteen, I think. I want to get rid of the canteen here for a variety of reasons, but the biggest reason I want to get rid of it is because I just think it's asking for trouble, right? It's a security loophole. It brings them out in the open. It provides a venue for them to see each other and recruit like they did, right? They recruited each other. Oh, hang on. We need to lock these doors open so that these guys can get where they need to go. Yep. Like that. And they are opening into the fence, which is what I wanted, so that's good. All right, that one was placed. Yep, this is placed. Let's keep that open for now. Speed this up a little bit. Servo's installed. That's good. This is opening the other. This is opening the wrong way. Let's replace that. It's opening the wrong direction. I want it opening into the fence. Placing the different doors. That's cool. This remote door needs to be locked open. There we go. This is a box for a locked door. He's gonna put the door in now. That's good. Okay, this remote door needs to be locked open. Okay, so we should be good. Come on, Warden, I'm busy. I don't need your crap. All right, the identities of a number of witnesses in federal prosecution case have been leaked, and some of them are inmates in our prison. Hits have been taken out on them, but we need them alive. You need to identify the prisoners and keep them in one piece until their court date comes up, which is always in 99 hours. There are now 9 federal witnesses. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave it paused for now, just because I want to explain kind of what I'm working to do here. What I want to do is extend these walls up, like this is already doing. So these walls are a little bit higher now. So the wall will end up being here. And then what I can do is I'll put the door here. I'll basically open up one cell. It's still not big enough to be a one automatically, but I'm opening up one cell so that I can put the radiators and stuff. And I'll just put radiators through here. It's not a big deal. Whatever, fine. And I'll take back these windows as a way of like compensating myself a little bit, so I don't have to pay for the windows later too. So that's fine. These windows aren't doing much anyway. This one was, because it's right next to the radiator, but the heat really doesn't bleed very well through all the cells like that. I wish it would. Part of me wishes it really would, because if they're windows, then they are open through here and the heat should be able to flow, but whatever. Okay, so we'll let them get on that. These are open now, so they can move through here until I'm ready to set them up with... Actually, yeah, these are already hooked up power, so really all I need to do with these ones is take the door control system, connect it to these servos. Oops. Hold shift, Charlie. Connect it to these servos, and then as soon as the... should I open it up through here? Yeah, this one's not connected. Which one's this one? Connected to the other one way down there. Well, let's do it there. And there. I don't know, whatever. Yeah, anyway, so we'll hook those up to the servos, and now I should be able to take this remote door and close it, and this remote door and close it, and those doors should now open really well, because the utilities just ran through. It's not running through here yet. They'll get on that eventually, probably. Same thing with those and those. Okay, so now we need to find these federal witnesses, I guess. So let's open up our informant screen. Now, I could just look around and say, where are you? And just kind of find them. Like, this guy's federal witness. Put him in protective custody. Yeah, because, I mean, armed robbery is 100 years. The thing is, like, all the federal witnesses will have a 100-year sentence. Right? All of them will have 100 years. And this is so they don't get accidentally released. Let's say the game randomly chooses... I don't know this, all right? I'm not confirming that this is why the game does it, but I think this is probably why the game does it. The game is going to randomly choose some prisoners in my prison that are going to be federal witnesses, and I think probably why they did it this way is that they don't want the game to randomly choose a prisoner that is about to be released anyway, or about to make their appeal or their parole or whatever. So it resets their sentence to 100 years, and they've served zero of it, so that that doesn't happen, so that I have to do the full term, 99 hours, so they don't get released during the course of this automatically. I think that's why the game does it. Anyway, let's put this in protective custody, and I need to find the other ones. The easiest way usually to find the other ones is just to turn on one of my informants. I'm actually running out of informants here. A lot of them are getting released. I'm gonna have to start recruiting more. Like this guy. Like this guy. He's in it for 136 years. I'm thinking he makes a good candidate. And this one right here. Aston, France. Welcome to the crew. All right. So the ones with 100% coverage can tell me everything I want to know. So let's pick one that's relatively close to security. I think you are close. Let's get you in. And while you're on your way in, I'm going to look for federal witness. Right here. We found one up here. Right there, this guy. He's a federal witness. We'll get him in protective custody. And who else? Let's get the... Oh, here we go. We got one here. Let's get this guy in protective custody. What else? Wouldn't it be weird? Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, happy freaking day. Oh, this is so good. Happy. One of my Supermax prisoners is a federal witness. See, this is Patterson. He had like 800 years. Now it's been reset to 100. Wow. Oh my God. Oh, we have two of them. Is this Gordon? This is freaking Gordon. Oh my god! Hold on! You have no idea how happy this makes me. I mean, surely Scott Gordon is happy about this as well, but... I have to protect Gordon and keep him... I have to keep him safe. 99 hours, and then he will be released out of here I will be rid of him. Because he's a federal witness. Are you kidding me? He's killed like 400 people. Oh my god. Okay. Well. Wow. Wow. That's... wow. I don't... Thank you, game. Random game. Like, of all the things, like, of all the prisoners in here to randomly be chosen as a federal witness, it chooses two of my most problematic prisoners, right? Patterson and Gordon are the two most problematic prisoners in this entire prison, and it chooses both of them. RNG. All right, well, what I'm going to have to do, like, keeping Gordon safe is actually going to be tough, because... like, these guys are going to want to kill him. Like, all these Supermax guys are really going to want to kill him. So that's going to be challenging. Really challenging. Because I can't put him in protective custody. Because he'll just kill everybody and get out. So, it's going to be a really big problem. I think what I might have to do with Gordon... how do I do this? Because I can't put him in permanent lockdown or permanent solitary. His whole gang will go nuts the whole time. I might have to deal with 99 hours of hell in the prison. For the sake of keeping him safe. I can't put him in protective custody, but I can try and limit his exposure. Let's try this. Can I make it to where he never leaves his cell or yard, but he's not punished? I can do that, right? Yeah! Let's try this. Let's go... okay, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna delete this canteen. This canteen doesn't exist anymore. So, by doing that, what reason does the prisoners have to get out of the cell? The only reason they have to get out is to eat, right? Everything else they want to do is in here or in this yard. So if I keep him in his cell and in his yard, then the other prisoners can't reach him anyway. Because they don't have a reason to leave either. So what I could do... oh, this is gonna be... this is going to be... oh, this is going to be a challenge. Food distribution. We're going to do food distribution. I want to bring you to these cells. I want you to distribute food to the cells. Right? Personally. Right? Like, directly. The guards will bring them their meals. So, Gordon will be kept safe in his cell. Right? I can't put him on lockdown because the whole cell will be... I can put you on lockdown, actually. You can totally go lockdown. Permanent lockdown. I'm okay with you being in solitary, too, actually. Let's add 6 hours to your solitary. No, your needs are out of control. Actually, let's end your solitary. Get you back in your cell. So you can serve your needs. But then I'm going to put you in permanent lockdown. I unfortunately cannot do that with Gordon. Because that will create hell in the prison. Now, this says there's no canteens to serve it. But I gotta imagine that's going to go away, right? Is that going to go away? Because I've got the kitchen serving him food directly. I want to see if the guards take their food to them. Damn. All right, anyone who's not a gang leader, you're permanent lockdown. Lutheran, you're permanent lockdown too. Brown is not actually that violent. He's pretty tough. But I have no reason to believe that he would not try to kill Gordon anyway. So, because they're both gang leaders. Ooh, this is going to be challenging. Isn't this going to be challenging? This is... how the hell did that happen? I got so lucky. I still have other federal witnesses to keep safe, though, so I need to focus on those two. But my gosh, is that cool. Wow. And you know, here I am thinking I want to upload this prison to the Steam Workshop when it's finished, and I kind of wanted you guys to have Gordon, to see how you guys dealt with Gordon. But I'm not going to, like, reload the game because of that. Like, I'm not going to cheat. So, it is what it is. Man, that's cool. Federal witness right here. Let's grab him in protective custody. I don't know what to think of that. That's sweet. Is this guy being taken? Yeah, confidential informant. Get him into the security office so I can see where my people are here. I want to see where they are. Like, this episode was about turning on the... was about turning on that cell quality thing, but now, now we're gonna wait at least 99 hours to do that. Okay, so, yep, federal witness is there. There's another one here. Yep, right there. protective custody. Let's get that happening quickly, guys, because he's in the laundry. We need to get this guy. There's a guy in there I need to get, too. We'll get him last. See if I can see all the rest of them. Gordon. Patterson. So happy. That's going to make things so much easier in the prison, because then the only gang leader in the prison, the only gang leader that will be here, is the one that is so docile and nonviolent that I rarely have to deal with him at all. Oh, that's so good. Where is the rest? Where are the rest of these federal witnesses? It's just the one in here? Is that it? Go in there. Go in there. You. You're a federal witness? No. Come on, really? It doesn't say you are. It doesn't say you are. Why does the game think you are? You're definitely not, because your sentence is only 6 years. You're almost out of here. You were in maximum security for 6 years? Well, rape. Yeah, all right. Fair enough. Oh, this guy. Okay, it's this guy. Federal witness. Yeah. Protective custody. Wow. Okay, well, so now you've seen the progress on Prison Town. Still got some stuff to do here, but I don't think there's going to be any progress on this, because I think these episodes, I think the next episode is going to be all about protecting Scott Gordon, which sounds so, I hate saying this. I really, really don't like saying this, but I guess I have to protect Scott Gordon. You wanted your couch, and everyone else except you has a couch. Because I put it in three cells, and you just happened to be assigned to that one. Well, I'm going to keep you as happy as possible so that you don't get out, and that you stay there, and you be nice. And if you can somehow manage to not act up in 99 hours and not get yourself killed in 99 hours, as twisted and screwed up as it is, you will get out as a free man and put into protective custody and put into probably the witness protection program, and then you'll have your name changed, and then you'll be back here as a new guy. Gordon will probably return as a brand new person with a whole new name and identity, because I can't imagine he not being able to commit, you know, not being able to commit crimes. But it is what it is, guys. This has been fun. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Let me know that you like it, and subscribe if you're not already. Like I said, I'm also going to be doing lots of more streams on Twitch and stuff, probably after I get back from my vacation. I have a little 2-week period where I'm going to be way out in Southeast Asia, so I'm not going to be up near my computer, but that starts the 16th and goes till February, early February. But yeah, join the Discord if you want to chat. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.